Thank you, Jesus. Lord, we just thank you for another opportunity to come and praise and worship your name, God. God, we thank you for another year that you brought us through, God. God, we thank you for taking us into another year, God, that we have never seen before. God, we continue to give your name the praise and honor that is due to you. In Jesus' name, I do pray. Amen.
Amen.
Since I got 10 minutes. 10 minutes. 10 minutes. 10 minutes. There is your own. We're going to go to Isaiah, the 43rd chapter, starting with verses 18 and 19. Y'all need help to flip through it. Y'all know I told you what it was. We'll go. Do not remember the former things, nor consider the things of old. Behold, I will give you a new thing. Now it shall spring forth. Shall you not know it? I will even make a road in the wilderness and rivers in the desert. How many here want a fresh new start in the Christian life? We've all made mistakes. We've all had failures. We've all had setbacks. And those setbacks sometimes will enslave us to a point in our lives that we can't even enjoy Christian life. In John, the 10th chapter, 10th verse, Jesus says that the thief, the devil, comes to steal, kill, and destroy. But he also says after that, it says that I've come to give you life and to give you life more abundantly. Don't you know that the devil's job is to take your joy, take your peace, take your happiness? But God wants to give us a fresh new start.
That's right.
Tell your neighbor, God's giving me a fresh new start.
God's giving me a fresh new start.
Yeah, I ain't really say it like your name, but God is giving me a fresh new start.
God is giving me a fresh new start.
Over the last year, some of us have told God that, you know, we want a closer relationship with you. We want to pray more. We want to come to church more. We want to be more active, but we fail.
That's right.
But he still has grace and mercy over us, that he still wants to give us a fresh new start. So tonight, we're not going to dwell on the past. We're not going to focus on the past. We're going to focus on our future. So tonight, in 30 minutes, it'll be 2013. So we're going to start with our brand new life. So start. We're going to start with the letter S. We're going to stop making excuses for our failures. If we stop making excuses for our failures, we'll be honest with ourselves and accept the responsibilities of our problems that we have. Proverbs 28 and 13 says, a man who refuses to admit his mistakes can never be successful. But if he confesses and forsakes them, he gets another chance. Admit your mistakes, move on. The letter T, take inventory of our life. Our past, our mistakes, our failures, we're going to take inventory of those things that happened in our past. Because our failures are just an education. We're learning every day from our failures.
Right.
So failure is never failure, it's just education. The letter A, we're going to act in faith.
Come on.
2013, we're going to act in faith. The Bible says that faith is the key to changing our lives.
Uh-huh.
Faith of a mustard seed.
That's right.
A mustard seed. Matthew 9:29 says, according to your faith, be it to you, which means, you get out of life what you put into life. So if all you have is negativity in your life, all you're going to have is negativity in your life. Like Danielle said, she stepped all on our message. We can't have a pity party no more. The pity party is over. Feeling bad for yourself is over. Depression is over. Confusion is over. 2013, we cannot take none of this in our lives. But now, we have to walk and think more like Christ. So what we got to do is refocus. Refocus my thoughts. Refocus my life. Refocus my mind off of issues. Proverbs 4 and 23 says, be careful what you think. Life is shaped by your thoughts. So your mind is a powerful tool. We have to use the way we think determines the way we feel. So if I'm hurt, if I'm thinking I'm hurting,
right,
I'm going to be hurt.
Right.
If I'm thinking depressed, I'm going to be depressed. If I'm thinking confused, I'm going to be confused. So let's stop focusing on what is bothering us or what we don't want. Let's focus on what we want. And that's a closer walk with God.
That's right.
The letter T, trust. Trust God. God will help us succeed in any venture in our lives. He already knows what, he already has a plan for us. All we have to do is just follow his plan. If we stop trying to do everything our own selves and just put our lives in God's hands, we will be all right. So now I'm asking you the question. Are you going to start 2013 all right?
Yes!
So we're going to stop making excuses.
That's right. Come on now.
We're going to take inventory of our lives. We're going to act in faith.
Uh-huh.
We're going to refocus our minds.
Yes.
And we're going to trust in God.
Yes,
God be blessed.